All right, I'm taking full responsibility. Do you guys remember that episode we did? I don't know. It was just a few back where Nay and I took on the incomplete project of changing out a brake hub assembly on our own. Well, I told you I was not a professional and we would probably, I don't know, end up in a pickle like this. Everyone graciously reached out to us online and left some great comments, and I realized I screwed up big time. But hey, that's all part of learning, right? So now it is 10 o'clock in the morning. We have about an hour until checkout. We're on our way to the Tennessee rally. We have our Hanging with the Hanks rally here in about 3 days. And then shortly thereafter, we're going to Grand Design to move out of the rig for 3 weeks straight. There's a lot happening, so I figured what better time to take on an extra project? Oh, please help me. I'm trying not to be stressed out, but I figured I'd take you guys along for more of the journey as I explain how I screwed up. How am I gonna fix this in time? Well, strap in. We're gonna take this on right now. What are we looking in here?
Had to make sure.
You ready to lock this puppy up?
I'm ready to rally. I'm ready to take a tire apart. Not really. Not that second part.
There are some major concerns that if this does not get addressed sooner than later, that we can end up with some serious issues that could potentially cost us a lot of money. And, well, it could just be dangerous. Let's not put this off any longer, Kyle. Talking to myself, I'm inherently lazy. I'm working on it, but be patient with me because we're gonna get this addressed right now. And we're gonna get it done the right way. Can I just say that? It's gonna be done the right way. And the best part is now that I made the mistake, well, it's locked in tight here, so I won't forget it next time. Hey Siri, what setting on a Milwaukee impact gun has the best torque? Lower or higher numbers? The struggles of not knowing what you're doing. Okay, I just found this. Like, I can't believe I didn't recognize this before. Right up here is a setting for all the different torques. Now I just gotta figure out which one is the right one. Torquing me off here. Okay. Let's try this one. We're gonna try number one. I have a good feeling it's probably low speed, high torque. I'm just guessing. Siri let me down.
She's finally
She's
responding.
Listening to me.
She didn't like what you said.
That does not seem to be working. Hold on. That was one. Let's go to three. Oh, okay. Let her rip a little more, I see. I'm trying to get them off.
No.
Wow. Okay. See? See, the more you learn when you hang out with the Hanks here. This whole time, people online are
Wait,
like,
are you supposed to loosen it? Or just loose, like, we gotta take the weight off the tire.
You're right.
Yeah.
I got way too excited.
You did.
Hold on, let me put these back on. Cut that. Are you still filming?
Yeah.
Now I know. Thank you everyone for telling me this. I would have never guessed this. All I saw was a battery mode. I had to look up a little more.
Dang. The more you, hey, we're all here to learn.
Like butter.
Just loosen them. Just break them.
Okay.
Wow, so in Canada, we would have been okay.
Way to go, Carl. It's nice to have tools at work. Coming from the biggest tool of them all. So what happened is last time we did this install, I did not seat the wheel bearing properly. At the very end, I got it all greased up, the external wheel bearing, I put that nut over it and I just hand tightened it. Do you guys remember when that happened? All right, let me put that in. Okay, so that is the inner, or actually the outer bearing. Now that's in there. And then we'll put that nut on, put this nut on. Okay, they said don't over tighten that.
Just hand tighten.
Yeah, I think so. That's what I'm gonna go with. Well, apparently, what you're supposed to do is really tighten that up so that it pushes that wheel bearing on the inner raceway, I guess you should say. It really seats it inside the wheel. And then you back it off until it's loose. You maybe do it one more time where you re-tighten it, push it in a little bit more, back it off, and then you hand tighten it. Well, I just hand tightened it. Pop that bad boy up right here. Yeah, we know what we're doing. Have a good day.
Kyle just wants to play with wheels and bearings and lugs. And I am just excited to get to Pigeon Forge for a rally. And potentially Bucky's, right? Are we going to Bucky's today? My gosh, guys, we haven't been to Bucky's in over a year. And ooh, I can't wait. Getting some action.
You're gonna be such a professional.
Stop it, I'm not. I'm probably really screwing up already. But hey, it's the name of the game.
Well, after, ooh, is that too greased?
No, it looks pretty greasy, doesn't it?
It looks really greasy. She's greasy.
Did we over grease them or what?
Probably. They said when you, someone else in the comments was saying something about greasing from the zerk is no good. I don't know.
All we gotta do is pop this little retainer clip off, the actual nut sitting behind this retainer clip. We just need to tighten that up while spinning this.
And that's called seating the wheel bearing.
That's called seating the wheel bearing. Something that we completely failed to do. Like so. That was greasy.
So greasy.
How we doing in the comments so far? I feel like your mechanics are just sitting there like, this guy, you know what? This guy's a nurse, so you're gonna get what you get here. I watched a guy on YouTube, he swears you turn this counterclockwise while tightening this up. He said that's according to the standards, and I'm gonna do that. See how this is all so loose?
Yeah.
This is that nut I was talking about that I only finger tightened. Can you do a favor for me and turn this counterclockwise while holding the camera?
Okay.
I'm gonna try to get two hands on this. Oh, yep, yeah, perfect. I feel like we're getting a good seating now. Okay, right there, stop. Okay. So now that's super tight, I'm gonna back it off, because they said you never wanna have it too tight, because if you have it too tight, then that's almost worse than having it loose. All right, so now loosened it, put it back. Let's do it.
Again?
Two more times, yeah. I'm gonna really tighten this. Okay, nice job, Nene. Excellent.
Oh.
Sorry. I almost feel like that should be good. They said you could do it a few more times if you want, but...
And then you finger tighten it, right?
And then you finger tighten it, yeah. Right there, we should be good. Now she should be seated properly. Properly. Once again, we're not professionals. 100% do not follow what we do. Do not take this as professional advice. Go see somebody who actually knows what they're doing.
Or read the comments.
Or read the comments, because there's a lot of good information in there. Thank you all again. Let's get this wheel back on. Let's rock and then roll. Get it, rock and roll to Bucky's, because we're gonna be rolling down the highway now safely.
Okay, the dad jokes are just, there's no regulation anymore basically.
It's hot and it's only 10:40 in the morning.
Are you going to Pigeon Forge? You make it look like you're one of those shelter animals whenever the camera rolls, but as soon as I turn it off, you're gonna go back to napping. Well played, good job. I did want to answer a question that we get a lot through email. I want to answer it right here because I have a visual to show you.
I'm really glad we knocked this out. All in all, I'm really happy that you guys had commented this. I'm learning a lot as we go along, so I really appreciate you guys taking the time to share the knowledge with me.
With the desk situation and the chairs and the bookshelf, how we secure that on a travel day? Do we bolt it to the floor? Like, how do we prevent that from moving all around?
I don't want to show you guys this in anticipation that you're going to be like, well, I'm never going to undertake these projects myself. Listen, it's okay to learn as you go.
Because our desk is one of those motorized standing desks, we do not bolt that down. It is heavy enough that it does not move. So basically what we've been doing, and I'm not saying this is the answer, find what works for you. Sometimes it's trial and error.
And when things go wrong in the RV life, stop, reassess, and then continue going forward one piece at a time.
What we do is turn the bookshelf sideways. We do put tension rods in the bookshelf to prevent everything from shifting around, but I turn that sideways against the wall, and then I will wedge one of the chairs between the desk and the bookshelf. I will bungee that, and then the other chair is just pushed in on the other side. It doesn't really go anywhere.
I'm off my soapbox. Let's hit the road. Let's head to Bucky's and see what other adventures await us today, because I think we're gonna be in for a bumpy ride.
We're off. We're off to Tennessee. Rocky Top, Tennessee.
Breaker 19, come in. This is Tickton. No, Carl. Looking on, taking a load. We're rolling with the best of them today. We are rolling with the best of them. Over and out. We're rolling down the road safely. Tires on, so Carl's happy. Drives, I tell ya. Maybe we're just getting spoiled only driving like an hour and a half, but
I know.
I feel it in my bones right now.
Really?
Really.
Are you excited for Bucky's?
I'm so stoked for Bucky's. I want to try something. I think we should make our mission today that we try something we haven't tried from there before.
Supposedly, this
location we're going to is technically the largest gas station in the world. I don't know how long this one will be the largest in the world. You know, they're always building new ones. Supposedly Colorado's building one. There's more happening in Texas. I just want to know when Pennsylvania's going to have one.
Oh, it feels good to stretch.
I know. I still think we have like at least an hour and a half or 2 hours till we even get to Bucky's. But I agree, we should definitely try something new.
Plus, we gotta load up on some beef jerky. That's always some good road snacks. I love the beef jerky for the long RV road trip days. You just can't beat it.
All right.
All right, well, I'll just wait out here then. Please, take your time. Other RVers have the same idea.
Yep, follow the, if you're not sure where Bucky's is, follow the RVers.
Oh, look, a reflection coming through here. We'll wave at them, see if they wave. Oh, they're waving. Hi. Oh, they actually know us. Or do they not? Or are they just like, please make it stop?
They're like waving us to get it. They're like, get away from us. Oh my gosh, we might find our rally peeps here. This is called Bucky's Boulevard.
Dude, this is like a city. They put their own roundabout in. Don't worry, if we miss this exit right here, they got four more down the way.
And we got kids climbing out of cars.
Oh my goodness. Get that child out of the window. Go, big swings, big swings, big swings. Quick, I'm gonna have to have you back me up because I suck at driving an RV.
I'm so excited. It's been so long, Bucky's. I didn't forget about you. They don't have Bucky's in Alaska.
No matter how long you've been driving an RV, you still gotta like maneuver, you know?
Yeah.
You just can't get in the first shot every time.
No,
no never. One's that good.
Oh, I know you can't go in Bucky's, but you get to go take a break inside the RV.
Oh, so nice. One time I heard someone describe a Bucky's as a huge mix between a Walmart and a gas station, and I thought that was just the most well-said, articulate way to put it. Combining those two and putting them on steroids.
Let's go, let's go. Holy crap, this is huge.
Okay, she went to the bathroom. It's just us now, and to be honest, I kind of enjoy it that way more because I'm bringing the good energy, I'm bringing the good vibes. Let me give you a little rundown of what this place is all about. I have to go to my favorite section, the beef jerky. Look how much beef jerky they have. This is where the hardest choice comes into play. I don't ever know what to get. I usually end up getting the bohemian garlic though. I'm just such a sucker for it. What are you feeling?
We did the chopped brisket, but not the sliced brisket. So is that the same?
It is, pretty much.
No.
That's like, I've never drove a Honda, but I have a Toyota.
Well, what about the pulled pork sandwich? Because that's like...
Yeah. Have we had that one before?
No. I don't think so.
I'm going to do the club melt if you want to do that one.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. All right. Pulled pork barbecue. Oh, I'm so excited.
I have this weird question. Do you want to get... What was I going to get? Banana pudding. I heard their banana pudding is to die for.
And we'll share it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's try it.
You don't have to ever talk me into sweets. Like, I just go for it. You know, for being super busy... They actually do a good job with the flow of traffic. Like,
yeah.
With how many people in here, there's no line to check out, no line to grab food, no line at the soda machines, and it feels like you can get around. Like, you know when you go to Walmart and it's really crowded? Like, you can't really do much.
I need a drink, though.
You never have too much.
And we need some beef jerky.
Might need a basket.
No. Once you get a basket, there's no going back.
Oh, no. We're becoming those people.
I didn't get a cart. I got a basket, okay? Calm down.
You want to get this one a whirl?
Yeah, we haven't had it. And we got to get all stuff we haven't tried before.
I wonder if their voices ever go out from yelling that all the time.
And they have to
Mine would go out
They have
really
to whisper.
Quickly. Yeah, they're like, fresh, brisket on the board.
You get Bucky's anything. They're going to have a Bucky's car before we know it. Look it, we can get an auto shade for the truck. Beaver believer.
Game plan, we're getting lost in here. Yeah, we gotta go.
We gotta eat.
Let's go get a drink and then skedaddle.
Okay.
What? Dude, they've said that like 8 times since we've been in here. So you can imagine their brisket turnover ratio is pretty in demand, I would say.
The pickled beets, and then check out where we came in.
You're not over those pickled beets yet, are you?
I can't get over them.
Come on, stick tight.
Let's go.
There they are.
What if we got pickled quail eggs?
No, you're done. You are so done. You're so...
What's wrong with that?
Who gave this to you? Your mom or dad? Who had this effect on you?
I feel like my mom would eat something weird like that.
Now I need to have a talk with her.
Okay.
This is not acceptable.
Okay, I'm going to get another one. Two of them. Because I could just snack on them, honey. Yay, we met someone who's coming to the rally.
Already. I guess the pre-rally vibes are already starting right now here at the Bucky.
They got the right idea.
They got the right ideas right.
I'm so excited. So we get our own sandwich. We don't have to like fight over it like a married couple would.
No, and we're way past that.
Well, except for the banana pudding we do. Let me get, before you stir, let me get it. Come on in.
Dexter, we're home. Best part about living in an RV, we got our fridge right here.
Wait, are we gonna try that now?
I'm just gonna put it on ice just for a second.
Okay.
Don't lose your mind.
I'm freaking out.
Get it, girl. What do you got?
Pulled pork sandwich.
That's a good
stuff. That's a glossy, nice bun. That's some nice bun.
It's that good, huh?
It's smoky. Good. It's a good meat flavor, and the bun is super, super buttery.
Oh my gosh, look at that. Look at it?
It's just that chigala. Is so good looking, hon. Oh wow.
It's good. There's like barbecue sauce, ham, cheese.
The moment of truth. I'm like craving banana pudding right now. And it has those little wafers at the bottom. How good is that? Is it like a summer treat?
Yeah, that's so good. Oh my gosh. Here, try this peat bite. It's a banana in it.
Oh yeah. Bye neighbors.
I'm just gonna take this and I'm gonna go.
I'll see you later. Wait, just leave that.
Let's go to the rally. YouTube thinks you're gonna like this video that you see on the screen, so hey, click it, give it a shot. We'll see you over there.